But wait, there's more. We also have data dependencies that can cause pipeline stalls. Consider these two instructions. We add R2 and R3, put the result in R1. Then the subtract instruction here takes R1 and uses it to compute R7. We say that the subtract instruction has a data dependence on this add. In fact, we can have this data dependence, and there could be another instruction that produces R8 that the subtract also depends on. When we have a data dependence, that means that we cannot just do these instructions like they were loads of laundry that have nothing to do with each other. We have to have the add produce R1 before the subtract can use it. This type of data dependence is called a read after write dependence. We read something after it has been written, and that order needs to be preserved. This type of dependence is also called flow dependence, because the data flows from one instruction to the other. And it is also called true dependence, because there is really a dependence, as in the subtract needs the add to finish before it, because the value doesn't exist until the add is finished. So again, this type of dependence is called raw, or read after write, or flow, or true dependence. There are two other types of data dependencies. Let's say that there is later a multiply instruction that takes R5 and R6 and produces R1, so that later instructions will use that R1 as the result of the multiplication. So for this dependence, we say that's a raw, flow, or true dependence. There is a dependence between the add and the multiply. The add needs to finish first, and then the multiply needs to finish, because we want the result of the multiply to end up as the final value of R1. If we let the add finish later, then R1 produced by the add will be left in the R1, so subsequent instructions would see that value, which would be wrong. This type of dependence is called a write after write, or an output dependence. Basically, the final result, or the output for R1, is what's affected, and write after write, simply because they're both writing and we need to preserve the order of the writes. This write should happen after this write. The third type of dependence is here. The subtract needs to finish reading R1 before multiply can be allowed to overwrite it. This type of dependence is called write after read, because the write needs to happen after this read. And it is also called anti-dependence, because it sort of reverses the order of the flow dependencies. For reasons we will see later, these two types of dependencies are called false or name dependencies. So we have true dependencies, which are these raw dependencies or flow dependencies, and we have false or name dependencies that have to do with overwriting a value that somebody has written or read previously, or at least should read or write previously. Now, we have a read after write, write after write, and write after read dependence. So how about a read after read dependence? That's the only one that is missing here. Let's say we have two adds, both of which are reading R3. Read after read is not a dependence, because these two instructions don't need to be done in the order of that dependence. Pretty much, we can reorder these two instructions. They will still read the correct value of R3, so that is why this is not a dependence. The second instruction doesn't depend on the first one. It can be done before or after it.